found the Hiryu about 5:30 in the evening, and the anti-aircraft fire was terrific. And I made a mistake just checking around to see, make sure no fighters. I looked around, and once I turned around and looked behind me, I can see the back ends, the tracers. And they were, I don't know how they missed. I mean, no tracers were going over and under our wings. And of course, the pilot is taking very radical, evasive maneuvers.
Once again, the dive bombers find their target.
The decks of the carrier were full of planes that were lined up and ready to take off. But there was just so much explosions and smoke and fire all over the place, it was unbelievable.
Four direct hits on the Hiryu's flight deck, and a raging fire quickly envelops the ship. The last of Japan's Midway carrier strike force has been destroyed.
I was the last plane to take off from the Hiryu. I turned around to look back, and then I saw a bomb hit the Hiryu, and it was engulfed in flames. Enemy planes kept coming at me, so I kept fighting them off until my machine gun was out of ammunition. I had very little fuel left, so I had no choice but to land in the water by a destroyer. When I looked around, I saw black smoke from the Akagi, Kaga, Soryu, and Hiryu. I felt all of Japan's leading aircraft carriers have been destroyed. We have lost the war. I was in such a hurry when I took off that I left my pistol behind on the carrier, so I couldn't even kill myself. I knew there were sharks swimming around in the water where I was, so I was ready to let the sharks kill me off.
Night descends. The Americans return to the carriers exhausted, but confident they have won the air battle.
That night, we knew that we'd gotten the big four of the carriers that attacked Pearl. We knew we turned back a task force that looked vast and impressive, but the heart and soul was the carriers. Without the carriers, they couldn't keep coming.
The Hiryu will soon join the three carriers, the Soryu, Kaga, and Akagi, at the bottom of the ocean. The Americans have ambushed the Japanese before they could spring their intricate trap. Without aircraft carriers to provide protection, Japan's entire Midway invasion fleet is vulnerable to attack by enemy planes. Admiral Yamamoto has no choice but to admit defeat. He transmits a message to his forces. The occupation of Midway is canceled. Yamamoto must now make a humiliating retreat back to Japan. The Yorktown, the only American carrier damaged by Japan's massive Midway task force, sits helpless in the water. A salvage crew extinguishes the remaining fires. With no enemy forces in sight, a destroyer begins to escort it to the safety of Pearl Harbor. But beneath the calm sea, a lone Japanese submarine has managed to penetrate the American anti-submarine screen. Having shadowed the battered carrier for nearly 8 hours, it takes position and fires three torpedoes. One torpedo rips the escorting destroyer in half. Two others score direct hits on the Yorktown. By morning, the carrier will be gone. The Battle of Midway is over. The Americans have won a stunning victory. One carrier lost to four of the Japanese. 144 aircraft lost to 332 of Japan's carrier aircraft. Although badly hit, Midway remains in the hands of the Americans. No Japanese soldier has set foot on this tiny atoll. Marines survey the damage, the exhilaration of victory tempered by the hard realities of war.
We as youngsters, when we went out there with our new airplanes, thought we had a real good opportunity to do well against Japanese forces. And for us, it was a real come down, those few of us who came back to realize, you know, it's a real tough business we're in.
It would take weeks to rescue the many pilots who had crashed into the ocean. Time enough for the survivors to remember those who so valiantly gave their lives so others could live.
The first day of the battle, we got the Jap carriers, and that morning, the combat crew, all of us were gunners, gunned to breakfast, 18 of us. And that night, we sat down to evening meal, there were seven. That was hard to take.
Funeral services are held to honor the Americans who died at the Battle of Midway. They had faced a seemingly invincible foe, but had emerged victorious. The cream of Japan's expertly trained and experienced pilots has been wiped out, a loss as significant as the destruction of the carriers themselves.
I truly feel there is nothing worse than the war. I hate it. Innocent people kill each other in the war. There's nothing more cruel than that in this world. Unless you kill them, they will kill you. That's a war. That's why I don't think there should ever be a war.
For the Japanese pilots who survived, the conflict will haunt them for the rest of their lives.
It was so sad that my superior officers were called Hazane, soldiers who lost the war. They said they couldn't talk to us. They were so ashamed. That made us cry. We tried to cheer them up, but it didn't work. They were given new uniforms and transferred. They were told not to talk about Midway.
The destruction of Japan's four carriers at Midway is a fatal blow from which their Navy will never recover. They have lost the ability to attack at will throughout the Pacific. And the Americans will soon build a Navy that will overwhelm the Japanese forces. Yet, in a few precious minutes on June 4th, 1942, a small group of determined warriors with the most meager of resources overcame impossible odds, and in the process, forever changed the course of history.